Hey, in this video I want to show you how to set up Steam Hours Boost Bot for 24/7. I have to say, your account must be connected to Steam Desktop Authenticator so you can get shared secret code. Check this video to know how to do that. I will use a render host service. Go to this website and register an account. You can just use Google to authorize. I will leave all used links in the description. Okay, you can use the same bot as for Replit. This script runs CS2, Team Fortress 2, and Dota 2, and it's online all the time. If you are alright with that, you can just take this bot. But if you want to set other games, change status, or add more accounts, you should register your own GitHub account. It's not hard. Enter your email, password, username, solve the CAPTCHA. Then verify your email address. Answer some questions. Then choose a free plan. And now your GitHub account is ready to use. Open this link. It's the repo I use to farm hours. Click on this button, fork, and create fork. And now you can make changes in this script. Open index.js file. Click on this pen to edit this file. Now you can add more game IDs to boost hours. You can add up to 32 games for one account. You can get an ID from the store link of the needed game. This number is the ID you have to put in the script. And if you set the status as online, everyone can see your game activity. And invisible, if you don't want to show it public. You don't need to enter username and password here. You will do that when running the script. How to add one more account to the script. Just duplicate all of this stuff. But now you should rename all used variables, like this. I just add the number 2 to all of them. Username, password, shared, games, status, user. And do the same inside this function. I will use only one account, so I just leave it as comment, so you can just uncomment this part if you want to use two accounts. Now save the changes, click commit changes, and click it one more time. The next step, go to render. Click, new, web service. Choose the first one, and go to next. Go to your GitHub repo again, and copy the link. It's public repo so you don't need to connect your GitHub to render. Just paste the link here, and click, continue. Okay, in the name field enter anything you want, like Steam Hours. Go to runtime, make sure it's node. In the build command enter, npm install. Select a free plan. Then go to environment variables. Add username, password, and shared. And in the values enter your actual username, password, and shared secret. If you use more than one account, add more variables, like username 2, password 2, shared 2, and put the second account data. You can also add accounts in secret file, if you know how to do that. Alright, then run the script, click on, create web service. It can take some time. Go to logs to see what's happening. Okay, all is good if you see the same thing in the logs. Go to your Steam to make sure it's working. Then let's make it work 24 hours a day. You see this link, open it. And it's good if you see him alive here. Copy this link. Now you should add this link to some uptime services. First one is Uptime Robot. Register an account. Then create a new monitor, HTTP. Name it as you want and put the link here. I have to say this monitor is not really good for render. Let's use another service, cronjob.org. Register an account if you haven't it. Click create cronjob. Enter something in title. And paste the URL of your bot. Set execution every 2 minutes. And click create. Okay, now it works all the time. We use the free plan, and they give you only free 750 hours in a month. So, to work it 24/7 you can run only one bot. How to restart the script. Click, manual deploy, restart service. I have to say it's really unstable, so you have to restart it every time when it goes to offline. But it's free and it's working. If you want to remove the bot, go to settings, scroll down, and click, delete web service. Then how to make changes? You can do it only in the GitHub repo. For example, I add one more game to the bot. Save this file. Go to render again, click, manual deploy, and then, deploy latest commit. Okay, if you have any question, leave a comment. Thanks for watching.